Cancer, welcome to your reading. I hope you enjoyed the speed shuffle for your convenience. We're going to jump into this reading and see what's going on with you, Cancer. We have the energy of the elves, playfulness. So spirit is saying that you need to lighten the load in your life. You need to have some fun time, be playful. Spirit is telling you that you have wolf spirit, that whatever you're doing with your family, the loyalty to family really does impact your love life in a very beautiful way. You know, your person sees you, Cancer, as being someone who's very loyal and very profoundly giving. Well, hey, you're Cancer, right? Frog spirit is all about renewal, so you need to really take some time for yourself is what I'm seeing here. So I'm going to look at the overall energy and give you the framework or the foundation of your person's thoughts, feelings, intentions, and actions. Now, the clarifiers make all the difference in the world, so I will clarify each card as we go. So when we look at the death card, that is death and rebirth. We see this beautiful star in the hood. So there is most likely a situation, Cancer, in which you have had a breakup with someone. So when we get the death and rebirth card, we see Scorpio energy as your overall energy coming into the reading. Your person's overall energy is this very calm, you know, sort of the beneath the surface, this person has lots of emotion, but they're really not showing it at this time. We do see someone who's a master of their emotions, but in the recent past, the death card is their thought. They want to, right now, we see them in this energy of wanting to rebirth the relationship, have a reunion with you, and a committed relationship. So that's Hierophant energy is all about Taurus. This is Taurus energy and Scorpio twice. So Scorpio is all about death and rebirth. You may find a death and rebirth in Scorpio season. So let's see why the death card is here. These are their thoughts, okay? So they see you as a person who's very balanced. They see you as a Queen of Swords. At some point, there's something that your person did that required you to draw a line in the sand. And so they think that you are very much large and in charge, the Emperor energy, that you're very much in an autonomous, self-empowered mood about this relationship, and that you aren't really going to take any negativity, that you're not willing to go to any dark places with them. When we look at the Seven of Coins, they feel as though the relationship that when they think of you, they feel as though that they had a success that went unfulfilled. Seven of Coins, they feel as though you invested, you didn't really feel fulfilled in the relationship and that you really wanted more. They definitely feel as though they failed you is really what I'm seeing. They definitely feel that. So the Hierophant card is here. Why? Why do they think of you as a marriage partner? The Four of Swords. Ah, so in the past, it looks like your person, Cancer, definitely felt as though you were not going to be the person that they married. And now we see them in this very different energy, dominion, very much like, did I make the right decision? Your person does not feel they necessarily made the right decision. They felt as though they didn't really invest enough. And the King of Cups, look at that. They want to come back into your life. Scorpio energy and the Scorpio King is a very powerful, loving being. And we get this energy twice for them. So Cancer, why do we have the Four of Swords? So this is your person's feelings, their heart space. They're brokenhearted. They have, by ignoring you in their heart space, they broke their own heart. And they see you, you know, when they think of you, they feel as though you are the most desirable. You are the most desirable single person in their life. And that is how they feel in their heart space for you. See, we have the Six of Cups, love. We have the Six of Cups here, love. Your person wants a reunion with you. They definitely feel as though they failed you in the past. And now in their heart space, they see you as highly desirable. They want to, you know, have a reunion, a reconciliation. The Two of Swords tells me that in their heart space, they're afraid of what you're going to say to them because it looks like this person hurt you, okay? So when we look at that energy, we get the King of Pentacles. They put on a very brave front, but the Hanged Man is telling me that they're trying to look at things from a different perspective, and in their heart space, they love you. The Knight of Cups, the King of Cups, the Knight of Cups, both are tremendous cards of love. So the love is not in question. Their actions are for you, Cancer. The Four of Swords, why is it here? Why is your person feeling like wounded? The Two of Coins, ooh. It looks as though they had a chance to make a decision and they didn't make the right decision. Two of Swords, look at that. We have repeating cards here. Two of Swords, Two of Swords. They ignored your value and it cost them a broken heart. You know, they didn't want to deal and they don't want to deal with any kind of complaints. No complaint department here, Cancer. I don't want to hear it. But you know, you have to hear the person that you love. And so we're seeing that we have two. They have ignored you, Cancer. They were in a process of considering someone else. And all that happened was they broke their own heart. You know, they've severed the relationship with you, or inadvertently had an argument or made you feel unloved or unwanted. And now it's coming home to roost for them. The Three of Cups card is their intention. They do intention a reunion with you. Mercury is retrograde. Okay. And their intention is to make an offer to you, but they don't know that you're going to accept it. Now, what's interesting about this person is they're pretty full of themselves. Your person has a lot of confidence because they're coming in. They're going to come in all very confident, almost a cocky vibe here, you know, because they're so defensive. Your person can really hide their emotions, Cancer. They really can. So why is the Three of Cups here in terms of your relationship? We see, the Empress. They see you as their Empress. So their intention is to get their Empress, to manifest this beautiful friendship, love, and Empress energy. Threes are the Trinity. This is Taurus energy. The Justice card, they are going to be honest with you. I feel very much that they need to tell you a lot of information to win you back. They do fully intend to win you back. They want to win your heart. They definitely want you back in their lives. And we see illusory success, though. See, they always thought that they could kind of get away with things with you. And now they're recognizing that because you didn't contact them, and it looks like, you know, when they ended a relationship, and it looks as though now that they want to offer you love, you're not looking so interested. In their intentions, they don't think that you're going to be that interested, and that maybe, you know, maybe, baby, that you really have other options and they really see you as that. So their intention is to try to overcome the competition. And that's what we see with the Seven of Wands and the King of Wands. We see the Devil energy. They are obsessed, Cancer. That is, you know, that is the card of obsession with you. They're not going to just let you go easily. So we see the Lovers card. Look at that. Gemini energy, your person is missing you. Whatever your physical relationship was, it was clearly very satisfying. They see the two of you. Look at this. We see these lights, you know, spirit is shining a light over their head, over your head. So for enlightenment about this relationship. Why do we have the Judgment card here? Because your person has released you. You know, they did in the past, but they lied to do it. And now they want a new beginning. So it's interesting that their actions are that they're going to, I'm going to say this is their actions, but they're going to lie to you about what happened in this relationship. And you're not going to have it. I can tell you that. You will spot a lie a mile away, a million miles away. And so they're intending on coming in and saying, sweet talking, doing whatever they have to do to win you back, but you've changed Cancer. You are no longer going to, well, not that you ever accepted it, I don't think you did, but for some reason this person's cocky and they think they can just come in and say whatever they want and somehow you're going to get fire in your belly and let them back. And that's what they're going to do. So that is their action. Why is it that we have the Judgment card here? Well, you had the strength to accept whatever they said to you. You're very strong. And so it says also it speaks to the fact that their desire and the way they see you is that you are a person of value, prudence, Eight of Coins, that you have kept working on yourself, that you have taken care of yourself, even though they released. And I see Princess of Wands. They are going to throw caution to the winds and reach out to you and talk to you. And let's see why the Seven of Swords is here. Oh, good. I'm so happy to see the card of the Ten of Wands. So your person is going to give up on this idea that they're going to lie to you very quickly. So when they think about you, they're feeling really guilty. Ten of Wands. That's releasing the guilt, trying to work through it. They did lie to you. They weren't very kind. And it shows that, you know, they're going to give that up. They're going to, good, loss of pleasure. So what we get here is a Five of Cups. You're going to get an apology. That's what that is. Your person's hanging their head. They feel guilty. They know they owe you an apology. They also know that they owe you an explanation for why they were in the Seven of Swords, sneaky deaky, you know, really unkind energy with you. The Princess of Swords says that they see you as somebody who's very smart. They do see you as a person who loves them, who has fire in their belly, but they also see you as very discriminating. And they see you as a person who you want to be victorious. And if they can't be victorious with you, you're not going to choose them. And what we have is the Fool card, Judgment card. They want you to take them back. So here we have the Judgment card where, you know, there was a release and they've seen you completely, in their viewpoint, you are completely unfazed. That you've gone on with your life, you've been very successful, and now they want you, they're going to ask you to take them back. They're going to ask you to reverse a decision and allow them to come back in. It does look like for some of you, they put you in a third party situation or they tried to tell you you were, because I got the Two of Coins in here somewhere. I can't remember where it's at right now. But we have the Princess of Pentacles, so they are going to make an offer. They're going to really hope that you will accept it. Why do we have the Queen of Cups here as their energy? Yeah, see, abundance, the Three of Cups. We have the Three of Cups over here also. We have the Three of Cups of reunion, the Three of Cups. They're in this energy of really missing you and wanting you back. You brought them abundant happiness, Cancer. So, you know, it's going to be important as you go forward to really be willing to, you know, be lighthearted with them and to, you know, just stay the course with who you are, Cancer. You're a beautiful spirit. They recognize that. They're headed back in your direction. And that is what I have for you, Cancer, for thoughts, feelings, intentions, actions. Tell me if you like this style of reading and how you like the clarifiers. Sending you love from Chicago. Hope to see you in another video soon. Thank you so much for joining me. Bye-bye.